The spacewalkers practice in the 6 million gallon pool at the Johnson Space Center. It's the closest they can get to zero gravity.
Motion is stopped for the stitch.
Okay.
4 stories underwater, there's an entire shuttle cargo bay and a life-size model of Hubble.
You know, the big thing about this telescope is it can point really, really accurately and hold its position, and it's the gyros that allow you to do that. But they're in a tough spot.
Got them?
I got your leg.
Yeah, I'm going to move in a little bit more.
We'll stick mass and my spacewalking partner up inside the telescope, in the bowels of the science instruments.
We got to be really careful around them. And I'm a big goon, and I've got to get inside of there. So this is the problem, how to get me inside this really cramped place.
He's got to work in there, but he has to be perfectly still, and he can only work with one hand right there amongst the fixed-head star trackers. They don't like to be bumped, and you knock them off their axis, and they're useless. And the whole telescope's useless.
Mike Massimino, otherwise known as Mass, has serviced Hubble once before.
Fun today.
John Grunsfeld on the left is an astrophysicist and mountaineer. He's had more visits to Hubble than anyone else. This will be the first trip to space for Mike Good. Slightly soggy hug from his wife Joan. Soon they'll be saying their goodbyes to families and friends. Shuttle arm operator Megan MacArthur describes the last hours before launch.
I always love being by the ocean, surrounded by dunes and, you know, seaside plants. It's very calming for me down at Kennedy, and it's just a nice place to go, kind of relax and let your mind wander a little bit and relieve you from the different cares about